that first day I held Margot, she felt like she was my daughter. It felt like we were meant to be together as a family. Hi, I'm Joel LaFalce, and I'm Vice President of Business Development at POPSUGAR. My partner, actually now my husband, and I met 9 years ago online on the first social network called Friendster. My partner's name is also Joe, so we're known as the Joes. I always knew personally that I wanted to have kids. So as our relationship got more serious, that kind of opened up conversations about having a family together. It's a very personal decision, and we found that the way that we wanted to create a family was really through adoption. We really didn't have any concerns about being a same-sex couple. We are proud of the life that we've built together, and we really wanted to share that with all the prospective birth mothers out there who were interested in finding a really good, loving family for their children to be raised in. I had some personal concerns just about making sure that we were going to be considered with the same frequency that maybe a heterosexual couple would be considered. Our birth mother was about 4 months pregnant when we were matched with her. It's almost like dating in a way, where it's like you are like getting to know someone for the first time, and all the things that go through your head: is this person gonna like me? Is she gonna like the decisions we're making? Does she like where we live? Does she like the home that we've created? Is the one thing that we're gonna say really gonna stick in her mind and force her to reconsider? Once we did get to meet her in person, we actually traveled to where she lives a couple months before Margot was born. A lot of that anxiety went away because we were able to put a face and a presence with this person that we've been talking to primarily over FaceTime. Some of the intimate things that we talked about with our prospective birth mother: what kind of life do you want for your child? Here's the way that we view raising a family. Here's the philosophies that we have around support and love and care and discipline, and just really like forcing you to think about things that, and to put into words, things that are often pretty conceptual. We were actually in the delivery room when Margot was born, and we were the first people to hold Margot when she was born. And even now, as a 2.5-year-old, there are times when we look at each other and I feel a bond between us that, frankly, I only thought would be felt with a biological child, but there is something so powerful about the bond that we have as a family. It overwhelms me. I will say what we've been really focused on for Margot's entire life is making sure that there is a really great squad of women around her at all times. So if she doesn't have like a mommy in the house on a daily basis, she has an emotional connection to a really strong set of women. We want to make sure that Margot doesn't feel like she's missing anything by not having a mom, that she just has a different family structure, and that she has that empowered female mojo in other parts of her life. What's special about POPSUGAR Family is I can't think of any other brand that is really embracing the diversity and inclusivity of how families are really structured in the modern day. Whether that is same-sex parents or mixed-race families or people that build their families through fostering, there is really now a singular place where people can go to experience all of the different ways that families come to life. I'm excited to share my story with POPSUGAR Family, because I'm really proud of the family that I've created. And I want to let my experience and my family's experience serve as a beacon and a guide for other people that are trying to create a family through adoption, whether they're same-sex couples, whether they are a single parent adopting, whether they're a heterosexual couple adopting. Every adoption is unique, and I think the more perspectives that you can get, the better understanding you can get for how that process might go for you. I feel like something like POPSUGAR Family was really missing when we went through our adoption process a few years ago, and even though this was only a few years ago, it really felt like there were a limited amount of places where we could go to really learn about, you know, what the experience is like adopting or surrogating through as a same-sex couple. Adoption for us has been an incredibly positive experience, and one that we are frankly hoping to do again really soon, to get a little sibling for Margot. So we couldn't think of creating our family in any other way.